So, if people haven't realized yet and haven't seen on the internet, it's been spammed and shared around so many different places now. But the Herohammer fanzine issue 3 for July in 2022 is finally out, and thanks to all the contributors who put this marvelous piece of work together, I think most people are very, very happy with how it's turned out. Mate, have you had a chance to flip through it yet?
I did flick through it. It's like reading a white dwarf that's actually good. It's got a lot of really cool user-created content. I was really impressed with it, and I just thought, what a nostalgia trip. That's awesome.
But
yeah, fair enough. I mean, my first impressions was just like, it's really like kind of like old White Dwarf style, and but the bits of White Dwarf we like without all the crappy advertising.
Oh, we love the advertising. I love the advertising. I want to see more of those. I always say to Hangel, please put more advertising in it, because I really like seeing those pages. And I think a lot of people get that nostalgia tinge when they see it. I think it was called Total Power or something like that, one of these fanzine type magazines that I saw that I've never seen before. And another someone posted like a Necromunda one the other day too, which I've never seen before either. So it looks like they've had quite a few of these sort of fanzine type based magazines released, which are, you know, being approved by Games Workshop and that kind of thing. But ours is, of course, not affiliated with Games Workshop whatsoever. So we've got our contents page here. We're going to run through just about every single game system you can think of. But I think it's mainly sort of a painting-centric kind of magazine, this one. Lots of painted models and all that kind of goodness in here.
Oh, that's weird. All I said was you skipped over your own models there in the inside page.
I did.
Cheeky of you.
I was.
Naughty boy.
But because we're here to talk about the fanzine, not my models. We're here to talk about the fanzine. Yeah. And we're talking about all the great news here from the Herohammerers out there. We've got some fantastic new art here by Drond Artworks, if I'm reading that correctly. It's sort of sideways, and with my illiterate way of reading, I think that's pretty close to it. But yeah, it looks very Silent Hill from the look of that, but very dark and twisted. Yeah. Bring Out Your Lead, of course, is coming soon on the 5th of August to the 7th of August. So if you didn't know about that, get onto that. Oldhammer Poland is, of course, coming as well. And that is at the end of August, September 30th to October 2nd in Warsaw, Poland. And of course, the Dutch Oldhammer Con, which we just covered in our latest podcast on October 29th. So three huge events, mate.
I can only expect some great photos for anyone in the community that's attending these cool events.
Well, I did tell Stuart in the Oldhammer Con to he's gonna put like a hopefully stream it through his Facebook.
Oh, that'd be awesome.
That'd be awesome. Like I said, mate, just put a bloody phone there, right, and just stream it through Facebook and just showing a game of like Man of War or Warhammer or whatever. I think people just love seeing that, and you can just hook it up and just leave it set up there the whole time. So hopefully,
That's technology level that we're in at the moment. It's great.
That's it, mate. Now, this actual campaign we're doing with me and Justin, it's like a Empire versus Skaven campaign. This is the second one. We've actually haven't got this to the table yet. So please try to play this scenario out and see if it actually works. It's probably totally broken and it's going to not work at all. But this is something I put together and Justin sort of confirmed saying, yeah, that's a good idea, or no, we should change this or whatever. But basically, if you follow the second issue, we had the very first scenario of this campaign, and we're trying to do these sort of linked, like the old campaign packs you had for 5th edition, and then each, depending on who won or who lost, would have different kind of scenarios set up for them. So the Skaven is sort of put in on the defensive, having lost the first game, and the Empire are coming in on all sides trying to wipe them out. So we've again, we've not played this game yet. I would love to get this on the table at some point. Justin has wonderfully had a baby girl recently, so I don't think I'll see much of Justin for a while, unfortunately. And I've just noticed there's a typo down the bottom. It's got Automat Ikali arrived. So there are probably going to be some typos and that kind of thing that we've missed, unfortunately. But yeah, if you enjoyed if you enjoyed the Warhammer campaign we're playing, please try it out. Please try it with different forces and make your own kind of campaigns and that kind of thing. Loony Bashing, what do you think of this one, Carnifex?
That's pretty hilarious. I never played fantasy, but things like Squig Riders and the Loonies and the Doom Divers, etc., like, were some of the coolest stuff ever. I like that goofball sort of humor.
Yeah, and it was really good. So Michael Becker, he sent this in to us. So thank you very much again, Michael, for that one. It's a great contribution, and I think people enjoy playing it. Now, if you don't have the actual models or terrain, don't worry. We'll have all these cutouts that you can photocopy and glue onto card and that kind of thing and use them. Angel, our guy who does all the graphic art, he's also an artist and done a wonderful depiction of there of a fanatic swinging his ball. I did one as well. It looks absolute rubbish, and I think people sort of lambasted it and said, Josh, give up. So I said I did. So it was bloody awful, actually. I'll have to take a photo of it for you. You'll have a good laugh at that.
Yes, please.
So, yeah. So we've got some nice photographs here from Angel as well with his nice fanatics there and all the rules you need to play this game. I've not played it myself, but, yeah, one day hopefully we'll get it out. It's a good beer and pretzel type thing. And here you go. There's all the charts and reference table and all the tokens you need for the game. So it looks quite interesting. Yeah. Yeah, it'd be actually good for a con as well. Like if you have like a demo sort of set up and you had this thing running in the background for people who are not actually part of the event, or just people like at the Dutch Old Hammer Con just walking in, you could have this as for something for the kids to play. I mean, I think the rules wise looks a little bit complicated maybe. But once, if you have someone who knows how to play the rules and that kind of thing and knows how it works, I think it will be quite successful. So
just jump right in.
Yeah, that's it. Now we've got the man. Arman from Japan, Ryogo Yamane-san. So thank you very much for doing this interview with me and his wonderful collection of primarily 5th edition, but you'll see some 6th edition models in here as well. I don't know where he gets the time. Yeah, I don't know where he gets the time to do this, mate, because I know most Japanese people have no time there. Obviously, he's quite a wealthy guy. He's probably got a good position in a company somewhere. He's got a good salary. He's got kids, and I just don't know where he finds the time to do all this stuff.
You can tell he's rich because he's got a giant room and he's wearing that sweater.
Exactly. And a wife that obviously loves him and devoted to him because he's bringing all the money in, and she just says, darling, you just go and do whatever you like. You go and sit in your hobby room and paint all night. Yeah, no, like awesome stuff. The collection's amazing. To this point, he's the only Japanese person I know who actually has a collection of 5th edition models and actually played during 5th edition. Now, if you weren't aware, 5th edition actually came to Japan as a translated edition. It was the first one. So people got into Warhammer through 5th edition fantasy in Japan, which is pretty awesome. I've actually seen the Warhammer Magic for 5th edition, the book, in Japanese at the local game store. The guy actually had one there. So it did exist, and people did actually play it. So, yeah, beautiful stuff.
Look at that terrain too.
Yeah, yeah, it's amazing, isn't it? So,
it's like the studio stuff.
Yeah, no, it's really rare to see this. So I was really quite astounded to see that someone in Japan actually had a collection of. I think I found Arman through Twitter, and I think most Japanese people, especially gamers, hang out on Twitter a lot. They don't use Facebook. They don't use Instagram or anything like that. So
yeah, I mean, I understand that with Japanese social media. Facebook's a little bit too intimate, I think.
Maybe that's what it is. And that, yeah, they can have a good alias and they don't have to reveal anything about their personal information, that kind of stuff. Maybe that's what it is. But Matt Hambert here, so Johannes Sorensen has read this article. It's more of it's for Warhammer Fantasy, but it's got a lot of 40K stuff in it as well. So it's like a bit of a mix between the two, which is quite interesting. So hope people enjoyed reading through that article. We've got Doctor the Viking's Orc Shop. I was going to say Orc Chop, but Orc Shop with a Gut Ripper tank. This would be down your alley, wouldn't That's it? Awesome. Kind of fix, the 40K stuff, mate.
Totally, totally. I love it. Any of the epic to 40K scale conversions, even the old Armacast stuff, it's pretty legendary. This is great. This is a fantastic guide.
Yeah, yeah. I mean, it's amazing what sort of stuff you can come up with in each article. So that's wonderful. Marcel has got his entry for the Call of the Crown. This is Call of the Crown 1, not Call of the Crown 2. And I just noticed another typo. It's got a Hig Elf army. So Hig Elf armies, they're a new thing. If you didn't know about them, now you know. So I'm sure we're going to find it might be a competition. We might have to do that, actually, run it through the Discord or Facebook group. You know, person who finds the most typos wins, and they win something. Marcel will have to send them something, I think. But yeah, he's got a really nice backstory to his army. Marcel puts a lot of passion and time into his projects, so it's really nice to see this come to fruition. And now Marcel has his own, I think it's a 2000 point high off army all up.
Yeah, it's pretty cool.
Yeah. Yep. So wonderful. Good work. We've got a modeling workshop. Now, Ted Gunnison, he's put a lot of these modeling workshops together for us. Well, I actually asked him to do it because he's done a lot of stuff on Discord and Facebook showing off, you know, things he's making. So, mate, you might as well share your knowledge with the people and who would be interested in making their terrain, because it's one of those lost long arts that I think people have now gone to the MDF kind of thing, and they just buy it and assemble it and paint it. Well, it's kind of the same thing. You just got to build it and assemble it and paint it, basically. So you're just missing one step. And you can make your own sort of really individual, beautiful-looking terrain like Ted has, and with sort of, you know, very cheap materials and minimal fuss. So
I'm glad people like Ted are putting guides out like this, because when I was a kid, I had no idea, and it was actually quite hard to access this sort of building material unless you went to a specific hobby shop. And now I think with the internet, we can all access this stuff cheaply, like you said.
Yeah, mate, absolutely. So it's all there at your fingertips. All the old White Dwarves had all those wonderful you know, terrain articles in there as well. Now we come to the Golden Hammer Painting Competition 2022 edition. A complete success, it says, and I'm sure it is. We had a lot of people entering, and, you know, this is all sort of in the dark to me, because I only realized, you know, all the entries, so I didn't actually see them until much later. And I was really astonished with the level of painting and the photography and everything that people submitted. Was really amazing. So we've got Bo Westergaard's wonderful-looking Troll Slayer unit here.
Some stunning stuff, really.
Yeah, mate. Yeah, I was really, really taken with the quality of the stuff. It just blew me away. So, you know, hats off to everybody who entered and who actually put something in there. Andrew McDonald, you've probably seen a lot of his stuff on Instagram or in our Discord as well. He's got a very unique sort of third edition sort of style to his stuff, and that's really cool. Actually, now I'm thinking about it, Bo submitted quite a lot of miniatures in this one, so I think he claimed quite a few trophies here, I think.
Gotta love some of those really old hammer monsters too.
Yeah. Yep, the old stone trolls and that kind of thing, the dragons, Trish Morrison's wonderful work there. But you can see a nice blend of third edition, third edition fantasy, you know, Rogue Trader 40K, and more of the second edition stuff there as well. Really, really nice.
Just excellent.
Yep. Our very own Australian Brian Collins is there as well, with his amazing looking Ultramarine assault group.
Yeah, it's perfect.
Oh, look, Carnifex, Alberto.
Yeah, I was very happy to see that, actually. My favorite model. I mean, first prize.
How many do you have, mate? I forgot. How many? I haven't actually asked you how many Carnifexes you actually have.
I've only got three now. I used
only
to have
three.
A lot more back in
the day. Jeez. Yeah. Well, after well, watching three, the Bring and Battle
three proper lead ones.
Oh, cool. Well, I was going to say, after watching the Bring and Battle second edition video on YouTube the other day, I think you only need one, mate. I think one will just be enough to just terrorize and destroy everything on the table.
One's enough.
They're not. They're called screamer killers for a reason, I think. So really cool stuff. We've got like the small scale entries here. Beautiful looking Man of Warship again from Bo. Amazing, that one. And some Warmaster stuff.
Stunning detail too. Like,
yeah,
on such small scale things.
Yep, brilliant. I love the dwarf miners in this one actually from Florian. I really like those ones.
Oh yeah, they're fantastic.
Yeah, because they're exactly like the 28 mil. They're brilliant.
Yeah.
Just excellent.
So good.
So yeah, you know, go and check them out yourself in the fanzine and marvel in their ability and skill in producing such wonderful paint jobs. Ooh. Lee's Night Goblin unit is really nice. I like that one. Mm. It must be the Goblin Green bases that got me, I think. It's attracted me straight away. So good work, Lee.
It's good to see red shafts on weapons too.
Yeah.
I know it's a bit controversial for some people.
We like a good red shaft. Yeah.
Yeah. We better not talk like that or the Bring in Battle guys. We've kind of got the market on that.
Now we've got Man of War. We did remote gaming, myself and Marcel doing the Sea of Slaughter. It's kind of like a campaign we're doing. And I hope we get this back on the table at some point because Paul's bought this beautiful new mat we're using for Man of War and I made some terrain for it. So it's sort of up the production value on the photographs anyway, because I'm using my old shitty, crappy foam board on these pics here. But if you're interested in Man of War, check out this wonderful little campaign game we've started with the Skaven and in the High Elves. It was a lot of fun, and I hope to bring it back again to the channel at some point. And I don't know if I've left a link for that, but I didn't actually. So check out the YouTube channel because I think we had a video up there. Maybe. I could be wrong. Now, this is my brother, Sebastian. He started drawing again. He was out of work and that kind of thing. So I said, mate, you got to get back into drawing and that kind of stuff. So he did. He showed me some pictures and I thought, wow, that's awesome. It's obviously a total ripoff of Mark Gibbons' Corn Berserker World Eater, but I think he did a smashing job. So thank you.
That Angel. Looks great.
Yeah, mate. Yeah, it looks awesome, isn't it? I'll get him to do a Carnifex next. That'd be a good one, actually. I don't think he's ever done it.
Yeah.
He'll really like that, I think. Yeah, more organic kind of a drawing to do. I think he'd really really like that. He loves doing skulls awesome. And that kind of stuff. So yeah, he did really well in that one. That was a really nice contribution. Then we've got Dr. the Viking with Warhammer 40K, the cowbunga.com. This is season two of the second edition army challenge that he's been running for quite a while now. It's been really popular. And here are the entries, mate. This is right up your alley here now, Carnifex. You can go for it, mate. Tell us what
you like. I love this stuff. look, you know, obviously I love everything here, but it's so good to see squats, especially the original squats. I'm not a fan of the re-released squats.
Thank you.
I know that's a bit of a controversial subject.
Not controversial at all.
Old ones are so good. They're so characterful, and there's a big range of them as well. And, yeah, thud guns are hilarious. It's very fiddly with a little like sort of four circle template and you're rolling dice to see which direction each thud goes. But squats had it all. Mole mortars, they rapier lasers, destroyers, tarantulas. They had all the coolest stuff. So I love to see squats. Everything else is pretty cool. I have to mention in the top right-hand corner with those Dark Angels, you can see some very, very old Terminators there. I think they used to – I can't remember the name of that particular type, but they're like prototype Terminators. It's pretty awesome to see. And, some absolute classics. Like behind Gazgul Thraka, you've got some Goth Orcs from the second edition box set, the plastic ones.
Mm-hmm.
I've been seeing a lot of people painting those fantastically lately, so it's really good to see the stuff. And then there's the evil Eldar, the nastiest race in 40K.
Yeah, and, now that's the man behind the Gathering Mighty Painters, who's a very humble guy, and he says he's not such a great painter, but bloody hell, mate, he knocks out some really nice paint jobs.
Yeah, better than my stuff.
Yeah, really good. Really good. Really, really
and
sort
Eldar
of.
Eldar are hard to paint.
Yeah, absolutely. Yep. Now, full of grays and yellows, that's really, really hard to get right, but I think he'd done a smashing job on those. Look brilliant.
So, yeah, good work.
Fantastic. Now, mate, I think you summed up really well there. I really like the names on the bases on the squats. Like, he's actually personalized them all. And, you know, the Exo Armor guys, Tron, and one guy, the musician dude, Siggy. I don't know what the musician did in because you only had standard bearers in second edition. So first edition Rogue Trader, they must have like musicians who played music and like bagpipes or something like that, or whatever, electronic bagpipes.
Rogue Trader was wild.
Yeah, and the thud gun's called Boom, named Boom. I think that's quite funny.
It's a very appropriate name.
Yeah, that's really cool. But there's more.
Yeah, so immediately, like, the orcs in the top right-hand corner, you've got that original sort of Rogue Trader era dreadnought. It's fantastic. The one that came after it, yeah, it's cool, but it's not as cool as that particular one there. That's awesome. All these models are fantastic. You got a bit of old and new here. Look at that Baroth, the Phoenix Lord, on that sort of flight stand. Man, that's ballsy. I would never do it. I'd be so afraid of him falling and snapping. Like, I don't know if I could play with it, you know. I'd have to have a stand-in.
Yeah, that's from our own Tom Reynolds. That's Princeps Tom on our Discord who did those. He's the master of many a project, and really good painter Tom is. So, yeah, wonderful. I think my stand-up for this one is Jonas. Now, Jonas is one of Doctor the Viking's sort of sparring partners for playing second edition. And he has his Instagram account, and he's doing like Space Crusade now. I don't know if you've seen those at all, Carnifex, but he's done an awesome job on those miniatures. Like, he's doing all the Gretchen and the Orcs, and all he did all the Chaos Marines and the Marines as well, all in this sort of really very heavily like weathered and kind of like more sort of modern technique type paint jobs, and they look really, really good. So if you've not seen Jonas's work before, yeah, he's done some really good stuff.
I'll have to check it out. That Predator is really cool. I love the sort of rust and dust effects and the chipping.
Now, is this a Predator Annihilator? Is that right? Is this the Annihilator version?
The later ones that came after the original beige plastic one. It's basically the original Rhino kit and then some metal sponsons and auto cannon turret. And then the Annihilator had the double las cannon that came
That's
out.
That's what
it's
it was.
A bit rounded. Yeah.
It had like two plasma guns mounted on it, something, didn't it? Whatever. I can't remember.
Oh, that one is the Razorback. That had a las cannon and two plasma guns.
Okay. There's too many variants.
Oh, there
of the
is
bloody
too many. I can't keep up with the modern stuff either.
It's like an encyclopedia of different tanks and that kind of thing. But like photography wise, like this really cool one with the Blood Skulls, Chaos Marines. Someone did there with the photography. That looks pretty amazing, how they sort of photoshopped those in. Some really creative stuff. Some really good stuff. Yeah, really good entries, and people come up with some really inventive stuff and do some amazing backgrounds and all that kind of thing. So it's really good to see.
So many good things in this mag, but look at that Harlequin Dreadnought.
Yeah.
That's insane.
That's another Aussie, mate, Martin. I think he lives down your way, actually, mate. So you need to get together and play some. Actually, I need to ask you about that, where he lives. But I'm pretty sure it's in your neck of the woods. So you guys should really get together and start playing some games, mate.
Have to go to the Sylvania Battle Games Club, eh?
It sounds like it, yep. Yeah, mate, do it. Yeah. That's an awesome-looking Harlequin Wraith Lord. That's amazing. So
Yes, so much good stuff. I mean, got to love people who are striving to paint in that old second ed style. I love
absolutely,
it.
Absolutely. Now, this is the Traveling Treasure Trove from Marcel. This is his initiative to basically, get a box, put all the stuff that you don't really want to donate to other people, send it to the next person. They take whatever they like and they replace that, what they take, with something they don't want. And it sort of goes around to person to person from country to country, and it's a really good idea. You won't get a cat, like is in the bottom right-hand corner. You will not receive a cat, so don't worry. You'll get all Lego figures that Marcel got with the bagels and that kind of thing. So it's a really good, fun initiative from the community, from our Discord. That's where it sort of spawned from, and then I think people have been really receptive to it. And yeah, they've put in their piles of things that they don't really want, but others, your trash is other people's treasures. So I think it's a really good idea. And I think we're organizing the second round of this treasure trove now that it's been around the continent.
Yeah, it's really cool.
Yeah, it's good, isn't it? Yeah, so it's a really good idea. Now we've got Planet Olhammer. Now Planet Olhammer, you've probably seen my interview with him, with Ian before.
Yep.
He's most notably on Twitter, but he's got an amazing collection of, third edition, mainly third edition sort of stuff, but really, really cool paint jobs. A lot of 40K fantasy in here.
Hell yeah. This is really gold stuff. Look at it. Oh, man, the cast off with the demon ass cannon, that's been doing the rounds. I've been seeing the original ones, and then someone made a really cool fan sculpt, and it raises a lot of questions, but it's quite hilarious. Yeah,
let's not go there.
I love the orcs from this era as well. Like I think they were called like nobles back then, and they had power armor, and then they became knobs.
Yep,
and they had various different armors, so very, very cool. And of course, the dwarfs from this era were fantastic. Look at them.
Mm-hmm. Yep, awesome.
Dwarf wizard, that's something you don't see anymore.
Yeah. Yeah, I think that's from a different company, though, because I know that the the demon arse cannon, that kind of thing's from old school miniatures or some other company.
Yep.
So, yeah, that's really cool. Really good stuff to see from Ian. So thank you for that. Now, to wrap everything up, we've got a Space Marine Battle Report, Warlords Battle between the Squats and the Orcs. Now, this is fought between myself and Paul, but we're using the lists from John and Gordon that were from the second issue of the fanzine, if I've got my memory sorted out there, but I think that's where it's from. So it's got Paul's Orc army cards and all that kind of thing. You'll see the battle report. It's an actual video we did of this as well. So if you can read it here, or you can go and check out the battle report on the video. Of course, we're giving everything away because we've got all the victory points, just like a regular old school battle report from White Dwarf. But yeah, really enjoy playing these epic battle
reports. Also really like Pablo's illustrations.
Yeah, they're brilliant, aren't they? I love this one with the Orc War Track and everything like that, with the knob on it. That's brilliant.
Yeah.
Absolutely awesome.
So good.
And, yeah, we should say that Pablo did the cover art and everything for us, so he's got quite a few of his artworks in here. And I think Angel sort of signed up a few other people with contributions for artwork, so I look really forward to seeing what they're going to bring in the future. But, look, I won't spoil it, even though you can see the victory points there at the end. But I lost. So I won't give that away. But I had a good time playing that one with Paul. And there you got the link there as well if you want to see the actual video. And you can go and check it out there. But I think that wraps up our issue 3 of the fanzine, mate. What did you think?
Yeah, it's pretty awesome. I'm really chuffed to see something like this. And everyone who contributed should be pretty proud of what they've achieved. It's excellent.
There were some beautiful sort of army photographs like set up there from Stefan and of course from Ted of his Chaos Dwarves and the Empire. So some really beautiful.
Yeah, I have to say the photography is excellent. Like everyone did such a good job.
Yeah, mate. I mean, everyone's really behind this, you know what I mean? So we can't make the fanzine without the community. It just doesn't work without them. So having all these contributions from people sending their photographs, or, you know, that's just brilliant. And people coming on board with interviews and that kind of thing just makes this magazine really, really special. Let's hope that there's an issue four coming up. Hopefully not too far away, not as far as the third edition came out, but as people would understand, people's lives are getting pretty bloody busy. So it makes you know, Angel's job a bit harder trying to get these issues out. But we're now looking at making the issues a bit shorter, and so we can get them out quicker and people can make their own articles and that kind of thing. So we're not relying on Angel to do all the graphic design and that kind of stuff. So we are looking at ways of getting the fanzine out at a more, you know, reasonable sort of pace rather than every... Oh, when was the last one out? Was it 6 months ago? More than that, eight, nine months ago. I don't know. I've lost track. But it's been a long time between the second and third one anyway.
So if people want to contribute an article, they can email somewhere, I'm assuming?
Yeah, you can email Angel at theherohammerfanzine.com@gmail.com. I think that's right. Maybe the herohammerfanzine@gmail.com sounds better. I'll leave links in the don't listen to anything I say. Just go to the links. I'll put the links in there, or you can email me and I'll send it on to him or whatever. So yeah, check out the links below for that. But anyway, mate, time's run out. We're going to have to say goodbye. But thank you very much again, Carnifex, for your time. I know you're not feeling the best, mate. So thanks again for coming on and to share this issue with me.
My pleasure, and well done, everyone.
Okay, mate, you take care of yourself, and we'll see you again next time.
Cheers. Thanks, man.
Okay, mate. Bye-bye, mate.
Bye.
Hope you enjoyed this video. Please check out our other content on the channel, such as painting tutorials, collections of other people's wonderfully painted models, our first White Dwarf series, and please check the links for our podcast and how to become a patron to support the show. Thanks very much for watching.